When the 60s arrived, the fashion image was transformed again. And pretty much thanks to one man, David Bailey.
That's lovely. Hang about, this is marvellous. Good. Open your mouth, Bailey.
Like Avedon, Bailey's life inspired a movie. But in Blow Up, there was a whole new ingredient. Sex. Before David Bailey, fashion photography in Britain was still a gentleman's trade. Bailey broke through all that, bringing an energy, charm, and incredible life to his images.
Let your eyes come round to me. No, you know how it was. And then lean slightly. That's it. Yeah, and then head back where it was. And just your eyes, I'm interested in that.
For me, Bailey is the perfect fashion photographer, combining technical brilliance with sheer force of personality to create pictures that have a sense of total spontaneity. He created some of the most iconic images of the 60s, and many of them were of his great muse and lover, Gene Shrimpton. And it's a picture of Gene Shrimpton that I'm going to recreate with my girlfriend Thule under the watchful eye of the man himself. I've known Bailey for a few years now, and hopefully he regards me as one of his friends. But really, to me, he's one of my idols. So getting a bit nervous about having copied this photo. He's going to be watching me, which is even more nerve-wracking. My girlfriend Tootie's a model, and we've done loads of work together, which is always fun. But we've never tried to copy anybody, especially a Bailey. So I just thought it would be a nice affinity between the two images if we use Tootie, even though she's got blonde hair and doesn't really have Jean's profile. Right.
Yeah, otherwise she's perfect. I mean, you could have got Naomi, I suppose, but it might have been closer.
Well, photographing your girlfriend is a slightly different experience to photographing
somebody else's girlfriend.
Somebody else's girlfriend, yeah.
Yeah. Well, good luck, Rankin.
Thank you. There are plenty of Bailey photos I could have chosen. I went for this one because you can see how it builds on Richard Avedon, but it's also got something new. A flirtatiousness that is so Bailey, and you can really feel the intimacy between the two of them.
No makeup artists or
hairdressers?
No hairdressers.
So what would you do for the hair then?
Just use a bit of wind. Mm-hmm. And that's wind made with a little bit of white card. I wouldn't have used a wind machine because it would have blown too hard. So it's just a little woof.
Okay.
Probably now to put the light a bit more camera left. Because I would have got rid of some of these shadows, but
I quite like that though.
I know, but it's not exactly perfect, but it has a magic moment, and her profile is just beautiful, isn't it? She just had a magic, this woman. This was taken on a Rolly Flex.
So we should have got a Rolly. So we're going to have to borrow.
No, I got one.
No, that's the right one, Angel. You've got problems. Just stand with your legs apart and face me. That's good, like that. Good, Angel. Yeah, it's nearly right. If that hand was nicer.
They're great, these cameras.
God, it's amazing, isn't it? And what do you reckon you shot that on, a 135?
No, I shot this on that.
On that? Oh, fantastic. So I've got no idea how to use this.
What can I say?
You can say, I'll help you.
I'll help you.
Before we started, Bailey dug out the prints from the original shoot.
That's beautiful. There's three of them, I think.
And how did you, would you tell her to do that?
Yeah.
You would have told her. I'm doing it wrong, actually.
Yeah. Yeah, it looks better on her.
Do you ever get that thing where you're shooting and you feel like it's quite a sexual experience?
I think photography is sexual anyway. Mm. Like Mr. Avedon, who thought it wasn't. Even with men. I suppose I fall in love. When they're in front of the camera, they're everything to me. Mm. I mean, they are the object of my love for that brief encounter.
How are you feeling about the shoot?
I feel that I've got a lot to live up to.
Mm-hmm. And what else?
What else? I'm a bit nervous, but that's okay.
Nervous of me or nervous of him?
I think the combination is the most terrifying.
The two of us together.
Absolutely.
How far do you think you were?
Well, you should be here, shouldn't you?
Yeah, no, I'm there.
Are you?
Yeah, I'm there, yeah. You know what? I don't even know if I'll be able to get this in focus.
It's not easy.
It's really not.
I'm left-eyed too, isn't that weird?
Are you?
Yeah.
Good girl. Good. That's good. Good angel.
No Polaroid?
No, I'm not going to. I'm going to do it just straight.
Live on the edge, are you?
Yeah, live right on the edge.
Good for you.
I'm going to just try and do it the way you used to do it.
Oh, he's better looking than you.
I know that.
Got some makeup for him.
Yeah. We need a bigger car. Okay, so it's just giving you a position. Yeah, that's good there.
Looks great.
Yeah, that looks great. Okay, stretch your neck, honey. And your hand was, your hand's more like this. That's great. Okay, let's get it. I'm just lifting that. Okay. Yeah, I got that one. Mouth open a little. Good.
Go on then, knock us out, girl. Go on. That's great.
That's it. That's it, that's it, that's it. Go on, go on. That's brilliant. Great, that's great. Really good.
What a great camera.
I actually really like it. It's cute. It feels, when you're looking through it, you feel good.
Yeah, you get addicted.
Of course, there are lots of other great fashion photographs from the 60s I could have chosen. There's Melvin Sikorsky's crazy pod pictures. There's Bob Richardson's intimate fashion portraits, which look like they could have been shot yesterday. But for me, it's Bailey's images that still stand out.
Good. Put your arm higher up, honey, at the back. Good. So now we're shooting digitally, just to quickly compare it to the experience of shooting with the Rolly, and also to show Bailey what we can do with it. Okay, go. Good, that's good, that's good. That's exactly what we want.
He's good, isn't he?
That's good, again. Okay.
How much longer? The original's going to fade.
Chin down a little. Okay.
Is it Simon over?
That's right. Good. I'm happy with that one.
No cheating, no retouching afterwards.
I'm not going to.
That's very nice, Rankin. Looks like a picture I did in the 60s.
And here is my version, shot on the Rolly. If you're watching, Bailey, I did manage to get it in focus. In fact, I think it's not bad at all.